Hi there! So, long story short, I started playing guitar around 4 months ago, and here's how it sounded back then. Yikes! Let's just say it was a difficult start. But now, after 4 months, I can even play a complete song, which sounds like this. Now, you might be wondering, what does playing guitar has to do with electronics? Well, the thing is, I actually got a second guitar, which not only comes with a built-in tuner, but also a 6.3mm output jack. So, by using a suitable cable, I can hook up this guitar to an amplifier, and thus I can easily annoy my neighbors with loud music. Brilliant! But not only that. Since we are now basically working with an electrical signal, I started wondering how easy it would be to modify it in order to create all kinds of different sound effects for my guitar. So in this video, I will not only be experimenting with a signal generator and a simple 555 timer circuit, but I will also build a poor man's version of an open source guitar effects board to find out how it sounds. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by Skillshare, which is an online learning community for creatives, where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Now, I said before that Skillshare offers very interesting classes about electronics, but for today's video, I instead had a look at classes about synthesizers. I watched one called How to Use Synthesizers for Music Production, created by Mikhail Backstrom, and that is actually the best thing about Skillshare in my opinion. No matter what subject you look for, you always find something useful. So why not try it out for yourself? You can get access to Skillshare for less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. And the first 1,000 people who sign up via my link in the video description will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. The first thing that came to my mind when thinking about electronic music was a synthesizer, which was how I started the research for this project. But oh boy, there is so much confusing information about guitar synthesizers on the internet. After around 3 hours of research, I was only certain of one thing. I needed some kind of oscillator that can create a sine, triangle, and square wave with variable frequency. By then either mixing this oscillator signal with the guitar signal, or letting the guitar signal control the oscillator signal, we should be able to get some interesting sound effects, at least in my theory. So let's find an oscillator, for which I luckily had this assembled function generator kit laying around, based around the XR2206 IC, which can output square, triangle, and sine voltages. By powering it up with 9 volts and connecting its output to an oscilloscope, we can see that it can spit out all the desired waveforms with variable amplitude and frequency. The only problem was that the max peak-to-peak voltage was around 5.4 volts. While the maximum voltage of my guitar audio signal was only around 0.5 volts. To mix them perfectly though, we need them to be at the same voltage level, which is why we have to add such a voltage divider in order to decrease the maximum voltage. After doing just that, we can see that the voltage is now ready for mixing. Before doing that though, I hooked the function generator signal up to my amplifier in order to hear how it sounds, and I actually kind of liked hearing the changing frequencies. So to mix them, I will be using such a summing amplifier, which, like the name implies, will create the sum of the individual voltages. After building it up and hooking everything up, we can do a sound test. Listen. As some of you might already have guessed, since we're just summing both voltages, we basically hear both signals combined, which is not what I was looking for. So this idea was a fail, and thus I moved on to the idea of influencing the oscillator signal through the guitar signal. In such a case, the oscillator would be called a VCO, aka voltage controlled oscillator, meaning the voltage of the guitar signal either controls the amplitude or frequency of the oscillator's output signal. And luckily for me, the pin 1 of the XR2206 is labeled amplitude modulating signal inputs. So all we basically have to do is to feed an amplified guitar signal into this pin. To do that, I built up a simple inverting amplifier circuit, which boosts our guitar voltage up to 8 volts. Then I slid the pin 1 of the XR2206 IC out of its IC socket, soldered a wire to it, and then connected it to the amplified guitar signal. And as you can see on the oscilloscope, my guitar is truly influencing the amplitude of the function generator's output. But the question is, how does it sound? I would say that it does sound interesting, but it was still not really what I was looking for, which is why I declared this idea as a fail as well, and thus it was time for a VCO whose frequency can be changed. For that, I came up with this 555 timer circuit, onto whose pin 5 we simply have to apply the amplified guitar signal in order to alter the frequency of the output square wave. So I built up the circuit on the breadboard, and after connecting its output to the oscilloscope, we can see how the guitar sound changes the frequency of the square wave. So once again, it was time to hook up a voltage divider, followed by my amplifier. Now, like it or hate it, but this was still not the sound I was looking for, which basically means that all my analog ideas were pretty useless. Luckily though, I found a site called Parasite Studio, where you can find synth projects that, unlike my attempts, do not suck. They often use a small microcontroller, which uses its analog to digital converter to read in the guitar signal. And then they apply their own little effects and spit it out through the microcontroller's PWM pins. Pretty smart, I would say, but I did not feel like using an 80 Tiny for that. I rather wanted to use one of my Arduino Nanos I got laying around, and thus I quickly found the Arduino Uno pedalShield. It is an open source project from the site ElectroSmash, from which you can also order a kit for this project to support their efforts. But I didn't feel like waiting for such a shipment, which is why I checked what components I had on hand and started altering their schematic to make a poor man's version. First off, I removed pretty much all of the filter components, since I want to keep it super simple. It was also important that the input amp only outputs a maximum of 1.1 volts, since the code of the project defines that the ADC will use its internal reference voltage of 1.1 volts. So what I ended up with was this bare-bones schematic of the circuit, that should still work. Next, I brought in a small and big enclosure for the project that I had laying around. But sadly, the small enclosure was way too small for what I had in mind. So I guess I will have to use the overkill big box, onto which I first demarked spots for all of the externally hooked up components. Then I used the drill press to create all the holes, hot glued the status LED in place, and secured the rest of the components in place through the help of nuts. As soon as that was done, I created a small piece of perf board, onto which I soldered the female header sockets for my Arduino Nano. Then I added the IC holder for the op amp and continued by adding and soldering all of the components to the board and to one another according to my previously shown schematic. As soon as the perfboard circuit was complete, I hooked up the 9V battery connector to the power switch and the circuits, and soldered wires to all of the external components. Afterwards, all I had to do was to use the screw terminals to hook up the external components to the correct pins of the Arduino Nano. And after then adding a battery, we are basically done. So I headed over to ElectroSmash once again, in order to choose an example code. And as soon as I read DevPunk, I quickly went for it. And after uploading the codes, closing everything up, and connecting my guitar and amplifier, we can finally go for a test ride. Now in the upper position of the foot switch, the guitar signal is basically passed through to the amplifier without any modifications. But as soon as we flip the switch, the effect kicks in, which sounds rather awesome. Now all in all, my experiments were quite a big fail, but I'm rather happy with this pedal shield, since you can easily extend or swap out effects. And needless to say, they do sound quite awesome. With that being said, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!